during the break, the question was asked, and the answer is yes. Question was, should we play this kind of a simulation with the teams that we're going to be facilitating? And the answer is yes. It allows them to learn what you learn, and it's so valuable to you. That game took us about 20 minutes. It would probably take less with 10, 12 people. But the results would be the same. Always count. You may notice, those of you that have seen this for years, we always play spoons. We always play this. Here's the deal as far as we're concerned. If an unsynchronized team is involved in a planning process, they're going to create an unsynchronized plan. Job one is synchronize. Let them do their stuff. Bring them back together. Do something else to synchronize. Another simulation to synchronize. And I'm not talking about cutesy stuff like where did you do your last summer vacation. I'm talking about stuff that's deep learning. The rocks are kinesthetic. The movement is visual. That bang clap is auditory. Three senses. Always do that. Spoons is the same way. All three senses involved. So, yes, yes, do it. Having said that, last night, I want you to know this is less than a day old, what I'm about to tell you, because I guess I've always known the pattern, but I never put it on a piece of paper. I drew it this way because it's a graphic. And I titled it the 5-star pattern. That's kind of catchy, right? Star, 5. Could call it the 5-finger pattern, but somehow that didn't seem right. And I got the 5 T's because I spent just a minute and it became easy. The pattern is the rocks. I wanted you to do the 5 pieces because of this. Tell them what you're going to do. And then task them clearly so that they will succeed. Most tasks have anywhere from 3 to 5 steps. But always write the task down. It's in the chart. Big T, what I've suggested here is a little bit of an addition. Put a number in the T so that when you're looking at the charts, you can keep track of the sequence and make sure you get it all straight. So when it's over, this is hard. You can say, so what do you think about that? And people will have thoughts, and they will tell you. If they're having fun especially, they will tell you thoughts. Give you a chance to talk to them the way I do. But tell them, ask them to think about it. Tell them, what are your thoughts? The third piece is to take a break. After they've done that, take a break. Give the thoughts time to digest, people time to talk with each other about what they know. Here's a reality of life. People have cliques. Sometimes those cliques are polarizing. I talked about this a little bit on Wednesday. If you don't have some mechanism for people to get together with their clique and have a new idea and see what the other one thinks about it, perhaps in a positive way. If you don't do that, there's no way for a clique that may be dysfunctional to become functional. So take a break. Let people schmooze a little bit. Talk off in the corner. Stand around in the parking lot. Whatever it takes for them to get together with their buds for a few minutes. And that will happen as naturally as rocks speeding up. Don't omit that. As the thing grows longer, well, you're only going to have a couple hours at a wax. Don't worry about it. But in a whole day, you may have noticed yesterday that the breaks got longer toward the end of the day. I mean, I pushed you, but the breaks got longer. People need more time to talk about what's happening. Somebody reported that my head was hot. If you go over 6 hours doing this, you will have hot heads. And they won't absorb and do. take a break for that purpose, not just potty. And then when they come back from the break, process some of that. Talk a check-in before you tell them what to do next. The talk a check-in surfaces what happened here and here. And when you make that public and write it down, it is in the form of a commitment. Once people have said it, they're just about committed to thinking new thoughts and doing new things. Repeat it. In a 2-hour process, if you can do that 3 times, that's excellent. Plan on doing it twice, at least 2 tasks. You don't always have to write it down, but it's good when you're asking them to work independently so that you're not right there. Write it down so they know, look at it, and know where they are. Always give them a task that you're pretty confident they'll succeed at. And if they get close, call it a success. Thank you. What are your thoughts about this? It's going to be helpful. Take a picture of it, keep it on your cell phone, because this is a pattern. It'll repeat itself. The task will be different by that outline. The pattern will be the same. Any facilitation work that you do from now on will have to have that pattern embedded in it. It's reliable.